जाता है, जाने कब कौन जिंदगी का हिस्सा बन जाता है। कुछ खास लोग मिलते हैं जिंदगी में, जिनसे कभी ना बिछड़ने वाला रिश्ता बन जाता है। आदर, अभिनंदन, आभार, नमस्कार, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, हेलो एंड अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। अ वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू दिस एब्सोल्युटली वंडरफुल, beautiful and auspicious day that brings together all these special people like you. I am Parvati Venu and today I have the privilege of hosting the International Conference on Recent Advances in Material Science and Biophysics. Atithi Devo Bhava, our culture is so sophisticated. No words will embody the tradition and hospitality we carry. Brimming with respect, may I now request Professor Yerol Narayana, the convener of today's program, and Professor V. Ravindrachari, the co-convener of today's program, to escort the revered guest to the scaffold. Ladies and gentlemen, music is a milieu. The more you delve, the vast it moves. Music soothes the soul. While you find one amongst you, it's a talk of pride. We will witness the ecstasy of music that embellishes the sanctity of our culture of Karnataka and the traditions that embeds our profound Mangalore University, presenting the Kannada Nada Gite and the University Anthem. thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for exhibiting maximum potential energy. A prayer that is strong and deep will definitely receive God's answer. May all the gods and goddesses bless us all under the heavenly hands. May I request Grishma and Navyashri to invocate the blessings and pray for the day.
ವಿದ್ಯಾದಿದೇವತೆ ಸಜ್ಜನ ವಂದಿತೆ ಶೋಭಿತೆ ಸುರ ಪ್ರಖ್ಯಾತೆ ಕಮಲಜವನಿತೆ ಅಂಬುಜನೇತ್ರೆ ಕಮಲಜವನಿತೆ ಅಂಬುಜನೇತ್ರೆ ಬುದ್ಧಿಯ ಬೆಳಗಿಸು ಮಾತೆ ಅನವರತವು ನೆಲಿ ವಿಭು ನಿನ್ನ ಅನವರತವು ನೆಲಿ ವಿಭು ನಿನ್ನ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಯಂಗ್ ಲೇಡೀಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಂಜರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವನ್ ಮೆಟ್. A formal introduction and a welcome would bring us all together. May I now request the Registrar of Mangalore University, Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, to welcome the mammoth of the personalities of the day.
Yelladigo, Munjanaya, Shubhodaya, a warm welcome to one and all. I have been given for the day a very pleasant task and a privileged task of introducing our tall, iconic, legendary figures that are here today for the day. At the outset, in the beginning, I wish to introduce the chief guest, Professor Jagadish Chennupati. He is a professor, Research School of Physics and Engineering, Australian National University. Professor Jagadish, as the head of the Semiconductor Optoelectronics and Nanotechnology Group in the Research School of Physics and Engineering, Australia National University. To his credit, he's got a long list. He has served as the Vice President and Secretary of Political Physical Sciences of Australian Academy of Science during 2012 to 16. Currently, he is the President-elect of IEEE Phototronics Society and President of Australian Metal Research Society. Professor Jagadish is also an editor of six journals. To his credit, he has with him three book series and serves on editorial board of 19 other journals. He has to his credit more than 880 research papers, of which 600 are of journal publications. He holds, to top it as a crowning glory, 5 US patents. He has co-authored a book, co-edited 11 books, and edited 12 conference proceedings and 15 special issues of journals. He has won the 2000 IEEE Millennium Award and received the Distinguished Lecturer Awards for IEEE NTC. He is a fellow of the Australian Academy of Science Australia, Australian Academy of Technological Sciences and Engineering, the World Academy of Sciences, US National Academy of Inventors, Indian National Science Academy, Indian Academy of Sciences, Andhra Pradesh Academy of Science, IEEE, and a series of lists. On the individual achievements, he is a recipient of the Peter Baum Award from the ANU in 2006, the Quantum Device Award from ISCCSE 2010, IEEE Phototronic Society Distinguished Services Award in 2010, IEEE Nanotechnology Council Distinguished Service Award in 2011, and Electronics and Phototronics Division of Electrochemical Society in 2012-13, Walter Bose Medal in 2015, IEEE Pioneer Award in Nanotechnology, 2015 IEEE Phototronic Society Engineering Achievement Award, 2016 MRSI Silver Jubilee Anniversary Medal, 2016 Distinguished Fellow of Chinese Academy of Sciences, 2016 Osa Halink Highest Civilian Award, Companion of the Order of Australia as part of the 2016 Australia Award, honors from the Governor General of Australia for his contributions to physics and engineering, in particularly nanotechnology. Probably I did not find even a single year where you have not missed an award. I extend on behalf of Mandarin University, on behalf of the Vice Chancellor and myself, a warm welcome to you, sir. You have we are blessed to have a luminary like you. Thank you. Next with us, probably no needs, no introduction, but still, he is a figurehead, and he is our own beloved Professor K. Bhairappa. I have a long list really in front of me. Professor K. Bhairappa obtained his master's degree from the University of Mysore with distinction, rank and medals, and PhD and postdoc both from Moscow State University, Russia. At that time rated as one of the top 10 universities in the world during that time. He has spent more than 31 years of teaching in the University of Mysore in different capacities before his taking up his tenure as the Vice Chancellor of Mangalore University from June 2014. He is a specialized area being material science, nanotechnology, solid state science, crystal growth, chemistry of materials, crystallography, crystal chemistry, experimental mineralogy, and environmental science. He is involved in interdisciplinary research work of worth nearly 65 crores at the University of Mysore and has successfully been guided 20 students for their doctoral work for PhD, and about 8 scholars are still currently under his guidance. The highlight of his career is individual contribution to the H index in the University of Mysore is about 25%. That is individual contribution to the University of Mysore, I reiterate. That is really a tall order for anybody. 25% of university share by an individual, with the most highly cited papers to his credit. He is the founder coordinator of MTech course in Material Science, Center for Material Science and Technology. He is the chief coordinator for the project of University with Potential for Excellence, and also the coordinator for the Center with Potential for Excellence in a particular area, and also the founder director of Internal Quality Assurance, CEL, at the University of Mysore. He has been a recognized guide as PhD guide in physics, chemistry, material science, earth science, environmental science, biotechnology, microbiology. After his PhD from Russia, he has worked in several international laboratories abroad and visited more than 72 countries. A renowned academician and researcher, Professor Bhairappa has over 335 research publications in international journals with more than 5,900 citations and is known as a world authority in hydrothermal technology. He has over 31 book chapters and reviews and has edited 10 books and authored a famous handbook of hydrothermal technology, publisher, Elvia Publishers, UK, in 2 editions, and the 3rd edition is in preparation. He is serving as editor-in-chief and senior associate editor, and also the editor of several international journals from highly reputed international publishers. Also, he has edited about 5 special editions of material science journal published by international publishers from USA, UK and Germany. He is an elected fellow, Royal Society of Chemistry, London, UK, elected fellow of the World Academy of Ceramics, Italy, and also an elected fellow of Asia Pacific Academy of Materials, Japan. Also the Secretary General of Asia Pacific Academy of Materials. He has received several awards like Dr. Raja Ramana Award for Science and Technology 2011, the highest state award from Karnataka government, the Sir C.V. Raman Award in Physical Sciences 1998. I wish, give him a big hand for that. Material Research Society of India Medal 2004 and the Golden Jubilee Awards twice during 1987 and 1992 for the best research work in the University of Mysore. Further, a Jubilee crown, he was awarded the Sir C.V. Raman Birth Centenary Award for the year 2016-17 by the Honorable Prime Minister of India in recognition of his contribution to science and technology in India. Also, he has received the Attractive Paper Award in the International 11 Conference on Crystal Growth, held in Japan during August 1989. He has also been conferred the Educational Leadership Award by Vijayamini, Bangalore in 2015. He is also serving in the international bodies and Indian National Academy and the committees. He has widely traveled all over the world and has spent about 15 years in Japan, Russia, USA, Spain, Germany, England, etc. Currently, as the Vice Chancellor of Mangalore University, he is involved in several innovative programs to promote Mangalore University. For the first time, he has brought more than 200 international students on the campus from over 32 countries to Mangalore University. He is promoting interdisciplinary research. He has brought some of the finest academicians. Today too, we have a galaxy of luminaries among us. The campus beautification is given the highest priority with cleanliness and environmental awareness among the students. E-governance, campus-wide Wi-Fi and sophisticated campus surveillance system has also been provided. In a true sense, I'm not to exaggerate, we have, Professor Jagdish, I hope you agree, you come from a place which is known for cricket. We have a captain who is really a true all-rounder in every sense of the cricketing terminology. He's a true all-rounder. Found him to work, I'm just 1.5 months old. He's a man widely traveled, has a wide exposure. He's got a vision where to take forward this university. To keep pace with him, with he and his vision and ideas, it needs something extra from our end. Further, I wish to add at this juncture, it is not only this. He already has made a vision document for 2030. The roadmap and the blueprint is ready, but it is only we to carry forward whatever is vision. Don't you think it would be our blessed need from God to have such a academically excellent man among us to lead us? A truly indeed an all-rounder captain we have. Sir, on behalf of the Mangalore University and myself, I extend a very warm welcome to your good selves. Along with these two legends in their own field, we have among the galaxy a few more Professor K. Suresh, CENS, Bangalore. Sir, I extend a warm welcome to your good selves. And we have you. Professor Ajay and Vinu from Australia. A warm welcome to you, sir. Professor Lalit Manoj from Delhi. Sir, a warm welcome to your good self, sir. Professor Vail Murugan from Chennai. A warm welcome to your good self, sir. Professor Anita Chakraborty. A warm welcome to you, madam. Professor Shanmugam from South Korea. Customary members of my other colleagues, esteemed colleagues, the coordinators for this and organizers for this beautiful three-day workshop on physics, on recent advances in material science and biophysics, Professor Elu Narayana and Professor Achari. I welcome on behalf of the university, myself, people in front of me, my esteemed colleagues from various departments, and my student friends from various departments, and all the people from the media, be it the mass media and the print media, and all others, one and all, who have gathered here. A warm welcome to one and all. Thank you.
On behalf of Department of Physics, Mangalore University, to welcome the Registrar of Mangalore University, Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash. A hearty welcome, sir. Flowers belong to the biological plant kingdom, yet they spread the physics of attraction and love, creating wonderful chemistry amongst people. May I request the president of today's conference to florally welcome Professor Chennupati Jagadish. May I request? Welcome, sir. May I request the convener, Professor Yerol Narayana, to florally welcome Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor K. Bhairappa. Welcome, sir. May I request the co-convener, Professor V. Ravindrachari, to florally welcome Professor B. S. Nagendra Prakash, the Registrar, Mangalore University. Welcome, sir. May I request Professor Boja Pujari, Professor in the Department of Chemistry, to florally welcome today's convener, Professor Y. Narayana. May I request Professor Sangappa Y. to welcome Professor V. Ravindrachari, the co-convener of today's program. Professor K. M. Balakrishna, Professor in the Department of Physics, to welcome Professor Ajay M. Vinu, Global Innovation Chairman, Director of the Global Innovative Center, University of Newcastle, Australia. May I request Professor S. M. Dharam Prakash, Professor, Department of Physics in Mangalore University, to welcome Professor Lalit Yam Manocha, Adjunct Professor, Mangalore University, former Dr. Raja Ramanna, DRDO, Distinguished Fellow, Kanpur. May I request Professor K.B. Vijay Kumar, Professor, Department of Physics, to florally welcome Professor K.A. Suresh, Honorary Professor, formerly Director of Center of Nano and Soft Material Sciences, Bangalore. May I request Professor Gopal Krishna Nayak to florally welcome Professor D. Vel Murugan, former head, present UGC BSR Faculty, Center for Advanced Study in Crystallography and Biophysics, University of Madras, Chennai. May I request Professor Devendra Pahej to florally welcome Dr. Anindita Chakraborty, Senior Scientist, UGC DAE Consortium for Scientific Research, Kolkata Center. A very, very hearty welcome to one and all. Wise words and wise persons are the two faces of the same coin. In simple, while you have an ocean near, why search for a meandering stream afar? No, less the one, we have a learned personality to elaborate the perceptions of the international conference. I take the adulation to call upon Professor Yarol Narayana. Sir.
Respected chief guest of today's function, Professor Jagdish, Honorable Vice Chancellor and President of today's function, Professor K. Bhairappa, our Registrar, Professor Ravindra Achari, distinguished scientists, dear delegates who come from far off places, my dear colleagues, and all my students. So when we have planned this conference, maybe slightly less than a year ago, when our Vice-Chancellor instructed me to have a conference of this kind on this campus, I had my own reservations, because today you will see conferences every day in our doorsteps. So I had my own reservations whether people will come or respond to our request. But today, let me tell you, the response for this conference was really overwhelming. We had received requests from so many places, and finally we could not even accommodate all the papers which we have received. So that is the kind of response which I have received for this conference. So I would like to thank all the authors who have really contributed for this conference. Probably this response is primarily because of the one name which was attached to this particular conference, that is the name of our Honorable Vice Chancellor. He had given me the liberty to interact with all his collaborators and friends, not only in India but all over the world. And I had the honor of interacting with them. And let me tell you, some of the finest scientists, leading material scientists of the world, are here today with us, and who will be delivering talks on various subjects related to the material science and biophysics. Ever since he took over as a vice chancellor, over last 3 years, so in terms of conferences, if I have to mention, if you take the number of conferences which were organized in last 30 years, only in last 3 years we had more number of conferences than if you put together all the conferences which you have organized in last 27 years. So that is a kind of interest and initiative he has taken basically to promote research on this campus. So let me tell you, because of his initiative, we could invite some of the finest scientists throughout the world, and they interact with our faculty and students, and which has resulted many collaborations. Probably you may wonder why we have to organize conferences, why at all we have to attend conferences. So let me tell you, the conference is one place where we interact with people. Basically, we share our ideas, and in the process we get new ideas so as to further our research. So therefore, this conference, where you have a lot of luminaries in the field of material science and biophysics, and they will be deliberating on different aspects of the current developments in this particular area. And when it comes to the material science and the developments which has taken place over the last 30 years, the world which you today see today, it is basically the research and development which has taken in this particular area. It may be the smartphone which you are using, or the kind of different sensors which you have in your high-end cars, or the nanotechnology which is being used in our life-saving medicines. So therefore, this
3-day conference will definitely give you a platform where you can interact with scientists who are really working in this area, and basically it will help to develop new ideas and new research areas in your career. So most of the time, friends, you may wonder, we just attend conferences and present our work. So the purpose of the conference is not just like that. So where you will have to interact with the senior scientists, where you have to share your ideas, so that is the only place where you can get your doubts clear. So today we think that we get everything in the internet, but let me tell you, most of the things you will never get in the internet. Only with interacting with the personalities who have spent their lifetime in studying certain problems, they will be solve your problems instantly. Now take one example. So you might have heard of the research Feynman, so who is supposed to be the one who has given the idea of nanotechnology way back in 1960, where he said there is plenty of rooms at the bottom. So that is what we are realizing in the form of nanotechnology and research today. So Feynman himself was a real scientist of 20th century, and he was very informal in all his actions. And he once said that he had a problem in his mind which was creeping up for many years. And the research, you know, once you are stuck at some point, you will not be able to make any progress. So therefore the conference is one place where we get our doubts cleared. And once it so happens that Feynman meets Enrico Fermi in one of the conferences, and he just put forth his doubt across Fermi. And Feynman says, within minutes, whatever problems which was creeping up in his mind for years, in minutes he got solutions for all the problems. So that is a kind of legacy of Enrico Fermi, and that is a kind of legacy of the people who work in that particular area. And Fermi is such a great scientist that he was closely associated with the Manhattan Project, where the first nuclear weapon was tested. And everything was new at that time, and people had no idea to test the strength of the bomb which they have exploded. Fermi had a very simple method during the time of explosion. He just took out a piece of paper from his pocket and tore it off. And during the explosion, he just thrown the paper pieces into air. By looking at the pattern in which the paper pieces settled down, he was able to predict the power of the bomb which was tested. So that is the kind of intelligence that Enrico Fermi had. So therefore, friends, in this audience also, we have very brilliant scientists, all from the contacts of our Honorable Vice Chancellor. Most of them are his collaborators. And I also had interacted with many of them. They were all very keen to come to this conference, but because of their commitment, maybe some 2-3 years back, they had commitment. And some of them have written to me that we are missing a conference which is being organized by one of the most brilliant material scientists of the world. So that is our Honorable Vice Chancellor. And some of them said, we really miss this opportunity, and we are reluctant to say no to this particular conference. That is the kind of words they have used. But friends, we have some of the finest speakers which have responded to our invitation, and they will be delivering lectures in the coming 3 days. And I only request that there are many Enrico Fermis amongst you. But only thing is, you have to become Richard Feynman to ask questions, to interact with these scientists, and to derive the maximum benefit of this particular conference. I wish that the next 3 days will be very eventful. You will have a lot of scientific interactions, and I wish you a very fruitful stay on this campus. Thank you very much.
Light and brightness has always been equated with positivity, and motivation is seen as the harbinger of good. Lamp of knowledge symbolizes the spread of information and wisdom, which will take place over the next 3 days. I request the galaxy of intellectuals on the dais to light the lamp and mark the beginning. Physics containing the recent advances is surely a treasure. May I now request the dignitaries to unveil the proceedings of the conference. We are also releasing the e-books of the proceedings. A person who proudly calls himself to be a part of Dakshina Kannada through his marriage and strongly believes pleasure of giving is more immense than pleasure of taking. His life is the best example to stand by the saying, failures are the pathways to success. He also says nanotechnology is a way of mimicking nature. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the distinguished professor of Australian National University, Professor Chennupati Jagadish, to remit the inaugural address.
Honorable Vice Chancellor and my dear friend, Professor Bhairappa, and the distinguished world-renowned material scientists, and Professor Nagendra Prakash, the registrar, and Professor Yaral Narayan, and the convener of this conference, and Professor Ravindra Achari, and co-convener of this conference, distinguished luminaries in the audience, distinguished guests, students, delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It's a real great pleasure and honor for me to be here today and be able to share my knowledge with you and learn from you about materials and recent advances in material science and biophysics. Materials play an important role in our daily lives, and the seat which you're sitting has got materials, and the clothes you're wearing has got materials, the watch you've got has got materials, the phone you've got has got materials, the computer you're using has got materials, everything we're dealing with in our daily lives have got materials. Of course, there are a wide variety of materials, structural materials, electronic materials, optical materials, nanomaterials, nuclear materials, and biomaterials, porous materials. So range of materials which we'll be discussing during the next 3 days or so, which are going to have a huge impact in the field of all the industry sectors of electronics, communications, computers, and energy, and range of other technologies, including national security and defense. So the developments in materials is going to really have a huge impact, and in fact, we'll be learning about the recent advances from many participants in this conference. I'm very much looking forward to learning from my colleagues while sharing our own research at this conference. Biophysics. In fact, we say that the physics of biology is a really unexplored area. Biology is a very complex subject. Physicists can come and then really be able to really give quantitative approaches to biology. Most of the biology is done in a qualitative way, and there is a lot of work need to be done, and hopefully the physicists will be able to contribute to that and also learn about biology. In fact, we are used to being physical systems. Biological systems are very, very complex. They're also very dynamic. So that's why it's a very challenging problem to really look at. And I hope that this conference will be discussing some of those challenges in terms of applying physics to biology. And certainly there's a lot to be learned, and also a lot of developments need to be taking place in this particular area. And I hope the physicists and material scientists should be able to contribute quite significantly to this recent understanding of the biology, and hopefully that will benefit the humanity as well. So whatever we do, it is important for us to ensure that will benefit the humanity and then our planet Earth, and so that whatever we are developing has got the lowest impact on our environment and while providing improved quality of life for the humanity. Conferences, as the conference convener has mentioned, are not only for learning about what are the recent advances, and the human interaction is a very important one. And we may learn something and based on what results have been published in the research papers, but we really don't know, before arriving at those nice results, how many failures in experiments have taken place. And the conferences like this will help us to be able to learn about those failures while talking to each other as well. And then in fact, the failed experiments will teach us much more than a successful experiment. And I always tell my students, and you really need to don't get too frustrated because a particular experiment is failed. In fact, you can learn much more. And in fact, that really helps us to be able to come up with a better experiment and then be able to really come up with a better technologies as well. Conferences also allow us to be able to catch up with our old friends and collaborators, and allow us to be able to make new friends. And hopefully this also leads to, due to the interactions among the participants here, leads to new collaborations. And those days are gone where you sit in a corner and then say that you do science. So the competition is no longer the name of the game. The cooperation and collaboration is the name of the game now. Because the problems which we are addressing, whether you talk about energy and environment and all these things, there's no single solution. No single individual can really come up with a solution to those problems. That means by collectively working together, we should be able to find solutions to those complex problems. So that's why the collaboration is the most important thing. The beauty of science and engineering and technology is that it doesn't matter where we live and what language we speak and what we eat. And then we can all speak the same language of science. And if you're a lawyer, the law is different in India, law is different in UK, law is different in America, law is different in Australia. But as a scientist, the Maxwell's equations are the same, Schrodinger equation is the same, and many of the physical laws or biological laws are exactly the same. So that really is a unique bonus for us to be able to work together and then be able to address the global problems, which will have a huge impact, hopefully, on the humanity and as well as the environment. Students, and you are the future of material science, and you are the future of biophysics, you are the future of the science and technology. So I hope you will really interact with the senior scientists and also interact among yourselves so that you develop those opportunities to collaborate with each other and also learn from senior scientists, and even you can collaborate with senior scientists as well. You don't have to confine yourself to among yourselves, and senior scientists also have got some problems which they don't know how to solve as well. You may come up with a creative idea. So that's why I encourage students to really interact with various participants in this conference and meet with the distinguished scientists and also fellow students. Also, sometimes when you're really looking for references or the next job, and then one of the people whom you met at this conference may direct you in a particular direction, so that also helps in terms of networking. And then in addition to the fact that what you learn, what you know, whom you know also becomes important in life. And I hope you make use of this opportunity to be at this conference and be able to network and then learn and then move forward with a bright and a positive thinking, because future of the science and future of this planet and future of this country and then the world is dependent on you. Thank you very much for your attention. Enjoy the conference.
Thank you, sir, for providing a very positive insight towards the research and humanity. An individual of broad bandwidth who can modulate himself into various frequencies, a wordsmith of about 350 research articles, traversing a path of around 75 countries, an interdisciplinarian of the first order, is the innovative administrator of Mangalore University, the Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor K. Bhairappa. With all humility and pride, I take this opportunity to invite him to remit the presidential address.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries on the dais, Professor Chennapati Jagadish, distinguished professor from Australian National University, Canberra, Australia, Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, registrar of this university, Professor Erol Narayan, convener of this conference, Professor Ravindrachari, co-convener, and dignitaries of the dais, the honorable scientists, distinguished scientists, Professor K. Suresh, Professor Lalit Manocha, Professor Ajayan Vinu, Professor Vel Murugan, Professor Shukumar, my dear colleagues, invitees and participants of this wonderful conference, media persons. It's a great occasion and opportunity for me to be a part of this wonderful conference on a highly relevant topic, recent advances in material science and biophysics, covering a variety of topics like material synthesis and processing, nanomaterials, nanoparticulates and nanocomposites, semiconductor physics, ceramic materials, surfaces, interfaces and thin films, magnetic materials, materials for electronics and photonics, single crystals growth and characterization, polymers, biophysics, nanobiotechnology, physics and chemistry of materials, DNA replication, recombination and repair, molecular structures and modeling, structure-based drug designing, molecular dynamics, and so on. Let me congratulate Professor Narayan from the Department of Physics and also all his colleagues, the faculty members and the research scholars who have stood by him in organizing this great conference and also bringing out this beautiful proceedings volume. And I was going through this. Let me compliment the organizers of this. Well, we are very lucky to have Professor Chennapati Jagadish. He is a distinguished material scientist who is well known all over the world, and a very big name in the field. He is also, recently he received the Professor Somia Award, and also he was in the committee to select the highest material science award, which was given to Professor C.N.R. Rao, von Hippel Award, the highest in material science, and he was one of the committee members of that award selection. So such is the status of Professor Jagadish. In this university, as all of you know, some of the departments are doing extremely good work: physics, chemistry, biosciences. These departments are doing a great work and contributing to the growth of this university in a big way. Our university's H index has gone up from 31 to 61 plus now, with the contribution coming from these departments. And the other departments have been encouraged in recent years, and even the social science departments have improved in their performance and they are publishing in good journals. The university, as all of you are seeing, has several innovative programs and adopting best practices which have been acknowledged by all other senior academicians and other vice chancellors from different parts of the country. And in fact, Professor Narayan was mentioning in his introductory remarks that Bangalore University is organizing a series of programs, lots of conferences, seminars, workshops in the last 3.5 years. Yes, I have been encouraging each and every department in organizing conferences, and the number has gone up. In fact, some of the visitors who came to this university 2 months ago, after seeing the vibrant campus with lots of activities, like when they were here, there were 5 different international activities going on in different departments, and these people were from other universities, and they said, we don't have this much of academic activities in our universities, but Bangalore University is doing lots of things without much publicity. Yes, I don't like much publicity, to be honest. I'm a silent worker, and people should see that, acknowledge, and get motivated to do, further for the growth of the university. That is my idea. And also our university ranking has gone up in the Green Metric ranking, international ranking. We are 231st in the international ranking, but in the national ranking, in Green Metric ranking, by an international agency, we stand number 3 in the country, in India, in this international Green Metric ranking. And we are one of the only 3 universities selected for QS ranking by a US agency, Thomson Reuters. So only 3 universities from Karnataka have been selected for this QS ranking. The trump card of this university is the adjunct professors, the top scientists, academicians from all over the world coming here every semester almost, delivering special lectures to our researchers, faculty members, and to the students, master's course students. And this, in addition to the conferences frequently being organized by the university, would bring in interdisciplinary research among the faculty members and collaboration, cooperation, as Professor Chennapathy Jagadish mentioned. Today, without research, collaboration and cooperation and interdisciplinary research, you cannot achieve much. This is very important. India has its own name and fame from the historical time. Even today, India has been acknowledged worldwide for its standings in crystal physics, crystal engineering, drug designing, and in fact in crystal physics from the days of Raman, Sir C.V. Raman, people know about the India's contributions, and G.N. Ramachandran and P. Ramachandra Rao. All these people have taken our country to the international level. And even if you take this nanotechnology, this was not new to our country. This was known from the Vedic science period about 5,000 years ago. People knew in India how to prepare the nano powders of gold, silver and copper. And in recent years, with the advent of high magnification microscopes like STM, SEM, TEM with high resolution, people could able to see the nano powders of gold, silver and copper prepared 4,500 to 5,000 years ago in India. So that is how the Indian science from the historical or the ancient time had its name. And today in drug designing, India is still a leading nation in the world, and thanks to some of the best crystallographers we have today in India. Let me quote here, when I organized a national seminar on crystallography, that is an annual event every year in different parts of the country, I had an opportunity to host this annual seminar on crystallography in the year 2009 in Mysore. You will be surprised, there was a delegation from the American Chemical Society with 40 delegates coming from the American Chemical Society to see what's going on in India in the area of drug designing and crystallography and the molecular structures. And today, molecular biology and the understanding of the molecular dynamics are the key subjects, with the docking studies leading to the modeling and further leading to the drug discovery and designing. And for all that, the basis is again the natural or the raw materials occurring extensively in India, the natural products, particularly the herbs from the Western Ghats. 43% of the world's herbs production comes from the Western Ghats alone, the Western Ghats of India, I mean. So that is the situation what we have in India, and if this is properly exploited, and we can be the leaders in the world, in the whole world, in the area of drug designing and drug delivery. For that, you need to understand the molecular dynamics and nanotechnology or nanobiotechnology. And in this context, this interdisciplinary research and the conference on biophysics and material science is highly relevant, and I am sure that the participants from different parts of the country and abroad would enjoy this conference the next 3 days, and you will interact and discuss your research problems and issues with the other colleagues in your research areas. And I wish you all the best. Enjoy the next 3 days with both academic and social events. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your constant encouragement and keeping our spirits very high. A great souvenir is a singular, tangible memory keeper, almost a metaphysical object. We are happy and proud to present a memento which holds the traditional art form Yakshagana of the culturally rich Tulu Nadu. May I now request Professor Bhairappa to present a token of our remembrance to Professor Chennupati Jagadish. May I request the convener, Professor Yerol Narayana, to present a token of remembrance to Professor K. Bhairappa. May I now request Professor V. Ravindrachari, the co-convener of today's conference, to present a memento to Professor B. S. Nagendra Prakash, the registrar of Mangalore University. Benjamin Disraeli says, "I feel a very unusual sensation. If it is not indigestion, it must be gratitude. I personally opine that more thanking isn't sufficient to portray our gratitude, but nevertheless we all hold a heap of love and adoration to all our guests who made this inauguration a grand eclectic event. May I request Professor V. Ravindrachari, the co-convener of today's conference, to thank the gathering."
Good morning to everyone. Respected Vice Chancellor, Honorable Vice Chancellor, President of this function, Professor Bhairappa, Chief Guest of today's function, Professor Jagadish, other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, dear friends, persons from media, ladies and gentlemen, I am standing before you to propose a vote of thanks. Friends, as we all know, human civilization has been linked with the materials development. From the historical perspectives, we know the different ages, the Stone Age, Bronze Age, like that. Now we are in the age of nanomaterials. In fact, nanomaterials and its utilities has been learned from the nature, and we know the Mother Nature is teaching us everything which we are exploring. Hence, a new material synthesis processes, tuning the properties of the material for a particular application for our convenience, is a continuous field of research. Therefore, this conference aims to bring the researchers who are working on various materials, including biophysics, to exchange their experience and research results on all aspects of materials. As our chief guest rightly pointed out, the interaction is the motto of science. Without interaction, without discussion, no science will grow. No, therefore, this conference is aiming in that aspect. Aptly, today this conference is being inaugurated by a famous scientist, Professor C. Jagdish from Australian National University, Canberra, Australia, who is an authority in the field of nanomaterials and technology. Even with his busy schedule, as our Honorable Vice Chancellor mentions, he is busy. Even his busy schedule, he is with us today and inaugurated the conference. And on behalf of Mangalore University and the organizers, organizing committee of this conference, and personally, I thank Professor Chennupatti Jagadish for inaugurating the conference as well as for keynote address. Thank you, sir. In this inauguration function, we have with us another distinguished material scientist, that is none other than our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Bhairappa, who is also an authority in material science, particularly crystal growth by hydrothermal technique, nanomaterials, nanostructure, nanocomposites, etc. As a Vice Chancellor, in the true sense, he is our acting mentor, administrator and guide, and took our university to greater heights, as we know, all of you know that. As a mark of his leadership, our university H index gone up to 62 from 31 within a short span of 3 years. His academic passion and the administrative skill is being reflected from his recognition by the other national and international bodies. Name a few. Recently has been elected as a Fellow of Royal Society of Chemistry, London, UK. Elected Fellow of World Academy of Ceramics, Italy. Also, they elected a Fellow of Asia Specific Academy of Materials, Japan. He was awarded recently Sir C. V. Raman Bhatt Centenary Award for the year 2016 and 17 by our Honorable Prime Minister of India, in recognition on his contribution to the science and technology. In true sense, as I said earlier, he is the source of inspiration for all academicians present here. As a leader, our university, he is the backbone of all academic activities which are going on in this campus, including this conference. Aptly, this inaugural function is presided by such a eminent scholar, good administrator and a mentor. On behalf of Mangalore University and organizing committee, personally, I thank our Vice Chancellor for presiding this function and for presidential address. Thank you, sir. Our registrar, Professor Nagendra Prakash, is very supportive in all our activities. Today, he is with us. On behalf of organizing committee and personally, I thank him for attending this inaugural function. Today we have with us various distinguished scientists who are pioneers in their field of material science. Name a few: Professor Monacha, Professor Suresh, Professor Velumurugan, Professor Ajay. On behalf of Mangalore University organizing committee and the personally, I thank all of them for attending this inaugural function. Today we have with us a scientist, researchers who are coming from different parts of the country to participate this conference as delegates. On behalf of Mangalore University and organizing committee and personally, I thank all of them for attending this inaugural function. I thank all the university syndicate and academic council members, chairpersons of our sister departments for attending this inaugural function. I thank all our sponsors, name a few: CSIR New Delhi, BRNS Mumbai, Syngenta Bioscience Private Limited Goa, SDM Education Society Ujre, Srinivas Education Trust Mangalore, Barris Education Trust Mangalore, PA College and others, and for their constant support and encouragement in organizing this conference. I thank, personally, I thank all of them for their support. I thank all my colleagues, friends from sister departments, research scholars and students who are attending this function, on behalf of organizing committee and personally, I thank all of them. I thank all volunteers who work day and night without rest to make this function a grand success. Thank you one and all. Personally, I thank Professor Narayana for his efforts in making this conference successful and, of course, this inaugural function also. Thank you, Lauren. I thank all persons from print and electronic media who are carrying this event to the public. On behalf of organizing committee and personally, I thank all of them in attending this inaugural function. I thank all our administrative and engineering division staffs for their constant support and encouragement. Finally, I thank all persons who are helping us directly and indirectly to make this function a grand success.